My name is Roslyn Russell and I'm Chair of the UNESCO Australian Memory of the World Committee. And I'd like to pay my respects to the traditional owners of the land where I am currently sitting, the Ngunnawal and Ngambri people, their elders and ancestors past, present and emerging. I'd like to welcome everyone to our ceremony to inscribe 10 new items and collections of documentary heritage on the UNESCO Australian Memory of the World Register. I particularly like to welcome some people who have come from in on this Zoom meeting from Leipzig at a very early hour of the morning to celebrate one of the inscriptions. Last year, 2020, was the 20th anniversary of the establishment of the UNESCO Australian Memory of the World Committee. This year marks the 20th anniversary of our Australian Register, to which the new inscriptions will be added, bringing the total of inscriptions on the register to 78. This year's new inscriptions are indeed a rich trove of documentary heritage of significance to Australia and to the world. They have been nominated by a diverse range of institutions and organisations, ranging from national, state and university libraries, a National War Museum and a parliamentary library, Indigenous councils and university centres of excellence, heritage networks and migrant communities. They encompass famous names in Australian history, William Bligh, Charles Bean and Jessie Street, and Indigenous communities and missions in the Western Desert and South Australia. Gaps that have been identified in our Australian Register, particularly in the coverage of the performing and visual arts, are now addressed by three of these new inscriptions. The records of early European settlement in Australia have been augmented by documentation of the population of New South Wales a little more than a decade after the first fleet landed in 1788. The stories of a migrant community from the mid-20th century onwards have been added to the larger migration or stories oral histories inscription. Unfortunately, several representatives of key institutions cannot be with us today. Dr. John Valance of the State Library of New South Wales, Teresa Chitty from the University Library, University of Adelaide, and Melissa Kirk, Secretary General of the Australian National Commission for UNESCO, under whose aegis we operate. They have sent their good wishes for the ceremony. Those of us present online today are experiencing a very different inscription ceremony from those we have held in the past. The unpredictability of the COVID-19 pandemic situation made it impossible to contemplate holding a physical ceremony, especially with people who would have had to have made arrangements to travel to a venue. However, we will do our best to celebrate the significant items and collections of documentary heritage that will be inscribed today. So on to those. First, our first inscription is AusStage, the Australian Live Performance Database that gathers together records in an online format of every live performance held in Australia. Our second is the diaries, photographs and records of C.E.W. Bean, Australia's premier military historian and the father of the Australian War Memorial, which has nominated these records along with other records created by Charles Bean, held in the State Library of New South Wales. The Migration Voices, Estonian Oral Histories 1952 to 2020 from the Estonian Archives in Australia join a number of other migrant oral histories already inscribed on our register in the Migration Voices inscription. The J.C. Williamson Distributed Collection of Performing Arts is a large nomination from the Performing Arts Heritage Network, the Australian Performing Arts Collection, Scenic Studios Australia, Seaborne, Broughton and Wolford Foundation Archives and Library Collection, the Queensland Performing Arts Museum, the Mitchell Library, State Library of New South Wales and the National Library of Australia. These are an enormous number of performing arts records we're very pleased to have inscribed on our register today. The Johnstone Gallery Archive 1948 to circa 1992 and the Arthur Davenport photographs 1955 and 1992 from the State Library of Queensland document a pioneering commercial gallery in Queensland that's very important in the story of Australian art. The Kaurna children's letters from the University Library, University of Adelaide, document children's handwriting in Indigenous languages from a mission, a Lutheran mission in South Australia in the 19th century. And the log of HMS Bounty by Captain William Bligh from the State Library of New South Wales documents the epic voyage of the Bounty, the famous mutiny on the Bounty episode, and the epic journey by Bligh and his those who were cast adrift with him in an open boat to sail. He sailed to Timor. That's a remarkable record. And the papers of Jessie Street in the National Library of Australia document the life and times of a pioneering feminist in Australia and one of our representatives to the inaugural sessions of the United Nations. The Settlers' Muster Book of the New South Wales Parliamentary Library from 1800 documents the population of New South Wales just at a point just over a decade after first settlement in 1788. And the Western Desert Verbal Arts Collection from the Nunyat Yarra Council Aboriginal Corporation and the ARC Centre for the Dynamics of Language, the Australian National University, documents efforts to take the Indigenous language back to communities and also to document practices of language in photographs and video. Every institution and organisation with documentary heritage inscribed on our register will receive one of these, a certificate in the mail very soon. I would like to thank Christine Yates and her team on the assessment subcommittee, Anne-Marie Conde, Margie Byrne, Nicola Cousin, Pauline Kirby, Julia Mant, Megan Martin, Carly Maloney, and Kimberly Webber, their rigorous and highly informed assessments of the nominations. The UNESCO Australian Memory of the World Program owes a great deal to your knowledge and critical analysis. Also, I'd like to thank Sarah Dodd for preparing the citations that are going to be uploaded to our website very shortly. Thanks also to Shane Brainard for undertaking media liaison on behalf of the Australian Memory of the World Committee. And finally, thanks to all those who have nominated their significant documentary heritage for inclusion on the register and the institutions and organisations that preserve it and make it accessible. If it were not for you and your work, our memory of how life has been lived in Australia would be severely diminished. As it is, with your help, we do not have to imagine a world without memories. Thank you.